Okey, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan selamat sejahtera. So, we will continue discuss about the anomalous configuration. In the previous video, I already discuss about what does it mean by anomalous, or in Malay, it is keganjilan, which is it does not follow the rules that we apply in order to write the electronic configuration. So, how to answer this question? So, copper, it consists of 29 protons. Since it is an atom, the number of proton is equal to the number of electron. That's why we can have chromium 29. And then you can write the electronic configuration 1s, 2s, 2p, 29 electron. So this electronic configuration we done for the expected. Expected mean we follow the rules, okay, of Bau, Hans and Pauli. So this is the expected, but in reality, or the actual, is is the actual. Okay, what is the difference between the actual and the expected? I think for orbital 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, it does not have any difference. But this one, we can see the difference. For 4s orbital, since the orbital only have one box too, so we cannot see the impact very well. But for the 3d orbital, we can see the impact. For this one, it is partially filled. But for this one, it is fully filled with electron, I mean. So which is more stable? The actual configuration is more stable because the 3D orbital is full filled compared to the expected electronic configuration. The 3D orbital is only partially filled. So this is how we explain the anomalous configuration. First, you have to write the expected configuration, and then you write the actual configuration. Then you give a reason in terms of its stability, and you have to mention where the orbital yang mempengaruhi tersebut. Right? So the anomalous configuration based on your syllabus only occurs at copper and chromium only. Oh my god! Sorry. This is represent copper ni. Oh, Okay. Alright. So betulkan atom, and then at the rest, I think it is correct. Alright. So that's all. And